So I think we can start. Good afternoon, everybody. So last time I started to teach assembly language, okay? I told you in your program, you write directives and also you write commands or instructions. I explain the difference between them. Directives are instructions to the assembler, so they are not converted to machine code. Our microcontroller are not gonna execute directives. This is just a command to the assembler, okay? That's why after you convert your program to machine code, you don't see directives, okay? Commands, these are instructions like addition, multiplication, whatever. And these instructions are converted to machine code. So these commands are executed by the microcontroller. However, directives are only executed by assembly. Okay? I give you, for directives, I started with the very common one, org, okay? And I told you org, this one is used for memory management, okay? I told you, usually for any program, we're gonna have two orgs, org 1000, org 4000. Here, this is where you wanna put your program in memory, okay? You can put, this is where you wanna put your data in memory. So my data is gonna be here, starting from 1000, okay? That data here means variable definition, arrays as well, okay? Any variable definition array should be here. Code, your program should be here from 4000 and it has to come this way, okay? I told you, I made it very clear. You can put, someone can ask me 1000 and 4000, is that something like universal? Everybody has to use 1000, 4000? For sure, no. You can put them anywhere, it's up to you. It's up to your management, you manage the memory. Okay, that's a good thing. It's a low level programming language, okay? So you don't have operating system, you have the memory and manage it as you like, okay? So you can put it anywhere. However, I selected 1000 and 4000 because the RAM starts from 4000 and I wanna use the whole RAM for data to give me the maximum space, okay? Also, flash memory started from 4000. This is a flash memory, okay? You know what is the difference between RAM and flash memory? Whatever you write here in this area, because it's a RAM, once you turn the power off, it's gone, okay? However, whatever you write here, okay, if you come back, you will find it, okay? However, if you work on simulation, I'm not sure it's gonna stay or not, because in simulation, you don't have a flash memory. Is that okay? But later in this course, when we start using this port, whatever you write here started from 4000 is permanent until you change it. Is that okay? So even if you turn the power off, you know. So also I explain how can you define variables. When I say variables here, I mean byte and words. That's all what we have. And for variable, it can be variable or it can be arrays. It can be initialized or uninitialized. And the way I explained it was very easy, just dc.b, define constant byte, and then you put the initial value here. This is for how can you define a byte variable. I made very clear that when I say, for example, org 1000 sum, so sum is the first one is gonna come after 1000. So the location 1000 is gonna be reserved, it's gonna be booked for sum. So every time in your program use sum, you mean this physical location. Actually, in your program, when you write sum and your program is converted to machine code, the assembler is gonna replace, it's gonna remove sum and write 1000. Is that okay? Again, but can you just use 1000? Yes, but it's if you write a big program, you will hate it. You're not gonna like it, right? Why? Because you have to remember numbers. You have to say, yeah, I want to get the speed. Speed was 1007 or 8, I don't remember, but when you use the English word speed, it's gonna be easier anyway, okay? And then next one, I. That's why I'm telling you, in your program, every time you write I or sum, when it's converted to machine code, it's gonna be replaced by addresses here, okay? Also, this is how can you define array of bytes, initialized also. This is a variable byte, uninitialized. So the only difference is just one letter, DS instead of DC, right? And then here, this is not initial value. This one doesn't have initial value, right? So here, someone tells me, okay, this is uninitialized. So when it means, because it's uninitialized, means I cannot read first. I have to write first and then read, okay? But if it is initialized, for sure you can read it before you write, for sure, okay? Because it already has some initial value. Same thing here. So here, one here means it's only one. You can put more than one if you create an array anyway. And I explained. So in the coming quiz, I'm going to give you tomorrow, I'm going to give you something like this one. I'm going to ask you to draw this one this way. Also, I'm going to ask you, I, when you write I in your program, I is going to be replaced by what address? Okay. When I write array, this one is going to be replaced by what address? And so on. Okay. So for words, if you want to define a very word variables or array of words, everything is the same, only two differences. The first difference is here you have to use W, okay, instead of B. This one difference. The other difference is every variable or every element should take two locations from memory, not one, two. That's the only difference, okay? And the way we store it, as you see here, we store the most significant first. For example, here, 3A, F2, right? So I'm gonna take two locations to this variable, two locations, okay? So we store the most significant first and then the less significant, okay? So same thing if you want to create array of words, okay? If it is like this one, array of words, so this is an array. This array has three elements. Every element takes two locations, as you see here, because it's array of words. Is that okay? This is for same thing, but for uninitialized, okay? Very easy. Any questions? Okay, now I want to explain. So now I explained how can you create variable and the arrays, initialize, uninitialize, bytes and words, okay? Now I'm gonna explain something else. How can we define a message? If you like a message, you know, we use messages in programming all the time. For example, you wanna ask the user to give you the password. So I'm gonna display a message here. I'm gonna say, please enter the passcode, for example, okay? Or enter the password. If I wanna display a message here, okay? This message can be an array, as you will see right now. So I can define it and I can store it in memory, and then I'm gonna take it and I'm gonna put it here. I'm gonna give you more details how can you do that, okay? But before I do that, you should know something. We call it ASCII code, okay? Quickly, what is ASCII code? Simply, ASCII code is we, as humans, we use letters, A, letter A, letter B, letter X, and so on. Processor can only understand one thing, ones and zeros, that's it, okay? So what can I do? So if I press letter A, right? So how I send this letter to the processor? Okay, very simple. So what we do, we have a table, we created a table, we call it ASCII table. I give you the table here, let me make it bigger. Yeah, so here, this table is gonna tell you what is the code for each letter. So if I click A here, A, actually you are gonna send 41 hexadecimal or 65 decimal. So forget the decimal. So I'm gonna focus on hexadecimal, okay? But for sure you can use decimal, they are the same. Anyway, you are gonna send ones and zeros anyway, okay? But anyway, so I'm gonna, but most of the time we're gonna focus on hexadecimal. So that means when I click letter A or when I press letter A on the keyboard, actually, you are gonna send a number corresponding to this letter, which is 41. Is that okay? Same thing. If I wanna display a letter A here, you have to send the ASCII of A. You understand what I'm saying? So this is like a translation, you need to translate because the processor can only understand numbers. Anyway, so you can see here, guys, every letter here has ASCII. So this is uppercase is different from lowercase, okay? You can see we start from uppercase. Here they are in order. So this one 41, B 42, C 43. So it's the same order of the alphabetical, okay, order. So you can see the difference is 20. So if you have uppercase A, and we're gonna do this later in this course, I'm gonna tell you search for the uppercases and to convert the same to lowercase or the opposite, okay? So how can you convert upper to lower? Cases, very easy. just if you have uppercase, I'm gonna get the ASCII, this ASCII. If I wanna get the lowercase, just add 20. So from uppercase to lowercase, add 20. From lowercase to 20, to low, from lowercase to uppercase, just subtract 20. Is that okay? Because you can see they are they exactly the same. The only difference is 20 for all numbers. Okay? Not only that, everything you have, like every character, like asterisk here, plus, minus, comma, dot, and so on, dollar sign, everything is space, even space. So ASCII of a space is 20. That means if I want to leave a space here, I have to send 20. Once you send 20, you leave a space because the space itself is a character, right? And also another interesting thing, numbers, okay? So if I want to display zero here, I shouldn't send zero. I have to send the ASCII of zero, which is 30, right? Same thing here, if you want to send one, you should send 31 and so on, as you see here. Okay? Also, if you have ASCII and you want to convert the ASCII to a number, for example, you give me 35. So I need to know 35. I want to get a number, the number, which is number five. So all what you have to do, just subtract 30. So if you subtract 30 from here, you are going to convert. And the opposite, if you have a number and I want to get the ASCII of this number, add 30. Okay, you can see here. So for example, if I have a number 7, okay, so add 30, so it becomes 37, so get the ASCII. If you have the ASCII and you want to get the number, subtract 30. Any question, is that clear? Okay, so what I'm saying, very easy. What I'm saying is that if you have a message, hello, please enter your name, accept the error message, whatever, I have a message, okay? This message should be stored in memory in ASCII code. Is that okay? And then all what I have to do, I'm gonna get this one from memory in ASCII code, sent it to the LCD, for example, as an example, to see it here, right? So that means also you can see here, all these letters, guys, need only one byte. So I don't need word bytes. All of them are bytes. So you do, a byte should be more than enough to cover all of them, okay? So let's see how can we do that. Here we have a directive. I'm going to explain it now. This directive is called FCC. Okay, so we finished. I already explained DC.B, DS.B, okay, DC.W, DC, DS.W. Okay, now I'm going to explain another new one. It's called FCC. So FCC is this one is used to convert letters to ASCII. Okay, for example, you can do something like that. This is just a name, any name, error message. So here I wanna define a message, okay? Or I wanna define a string in like C. So I call it error message, can be any name, message, error message, okay? And then I'm gonna write here FCC, okay? And then I'm gonna put quotation. You can see the quotation here. Quotation here. And then between the quotation, I'm gonna write the message, error, try again. Is that okay? If you do something like that, how this will be stored in memory, the way it's stored in memory is the assembler is gonna store it in ASCII. So you are right here, letter A, the assembler is gonna store here the ASCII of A. Letter R is gonna be next one and so on. So. You can see it as an array of bytes. Yes, it is array of bytes where every byte is one character. Yes, that's true. You get what I'm saying? So it's like similar, it's like if it is array of bytes. Yes. However, the good thing about FCC, I don't need to convert by myself to convert these characters to ASCII. I don't need to do it by myself. Just write it in English words and the symbol is gonna do it. You got what I'm saying? But it's, so any message, let me repeat this part before I continue. Any message or any string is actually an array of bytes where every byte should have the ASCII of one character, okay? That's how it is, this is how it is stored in memory, okay? So I have another example here, alpha. Don't tell me what alpha means, just a name, alpha. I just call it alpha, okay? And then FCC, and then quotation DEF. This is a message, DEF. So how, if you write it this way, how this one is gonna be stored in memory? It's gonna be stored in memory this way because you start from org 1000, So we're going to start here from 1000. Every character here is going to occupy one byte, as you see here. So here is going to be stored this way, 64, 65, 66. So this one is going to take three locations. Who converted these letters to ASCII? It's an assembler, not by myself. Okay. Can I do this way? Like, can I define array of bytes? Yes, I can say alpha, DC, the B. Okay. And then you can say 64, 65, 66. Is there a difference? No, they are exactly the same. The only difference is here, you are going to buzzer yourself, okay, to convert the characters to ASCII. So why I would do that, okay? Just write any message here, okay? And then the assembler will do this conversion for you, okay? Yes.
It's like
said,
like the last character must be the same as the first character.
Yes.
So, like 64, say,
no, what I mean here, yes, that's true. Thanks for this question. So what I mean here, the first character, I mean here is a quotation. So you can use something else other than quotation, but they should be the same. So I'm just making it easy and say all the time, just use quotation. That's it. You get what I'm saying? So you can use something else here other than quotation, but it has to be the same. That's why I'm saying just make it easy and just use quotation all the time. Okay. I'm asking about this one. I'm talking about these two. So quotation here is not a character. So you cannot see it here. It's just a quotation. The quotation is just, you are telling the assembler what is the beginning and what is the end. So it's not going to be converted. What is inside quotation, even space, every, what if I leave two spaces? Every space is going to be one ASCII, 20, number 20. Is that okay? Anyway, so any question here? So tomorrow in the quiz, I'm telling you what will be in the quiz, just study it. I'm going to give you something like that. For sure, I'm not going to tell you what is the word. I'm going to put a word here. I just want to know, once you have something like that, you can convert it to ASCII and you put it here, okay? Also, because this is array, also because this is array of bytes, if you use the word alpha later in your program, similar to what we did before, exactly same thing. If you use the word alpha is going to be replaced by 1000. The beginning, I said it before, if you have array of bytes or array of words, the name of the array is gonna be replaced by the beginning address, same thing, okay? So I see no difference between this one and this one, it's exactly the same, just the assembler is gonna help me to convert, but instead of bothering myself to do it by myself, the assembler is gonna do it, okay? Anyway, I think this, we have one more, this is the last directive, we have one more, maybe not very important, another directive I'm gonna teach right now. Look, any question here in this directive before I leave it? FCC, yes.
So on the quiz, will we have to be able to convert from ASCII?
Yeah, because you should, in quizzes, in this course, you can use any printed material. So you already have the ASCII table in chapter two, right? So just print it, and take it with you. Okay? Again, guys, look here, guys. Even if you don't have the table and you just tell me when you solve it, you tell me here should be the ASCII of T, right? Okay, so for sure the who's grades the TA is grading them, but the TA, as long as you know whatever there should be, the ASCII should be enough, okay? Now, any other question? Yes.
Sorry, say
it again. Why did you use BC.B
for that part?
Yeah, because this is array of bytes, not words.
Oh.
Because every ASCII, the ASCII, I don't need a word. Word is too big for ASCII, right? So as you see, if you look at the ASCII table, the byte should be enough to cover the whole, all the numbers. You know what I'm saying? Now, The last directive I have here, we call it equate. So what is equate? In order to teach equate, I'm gonna tell you something similar. You may have done in C language, okay? And I'm gonna explain it. And this is the equivalent one here in assembly, okay? So let's see. In C language, maybe you have done something like that. Maybe you didn't. I'm gonna explain it anyway. So we can do something like that. I can say hashtag define. Okay, so you have to use hashtag, you have to use the word that defines this keyword, and then you can put any name, this can be any name, And then you can put a number this way. Okay. So this one can be any name. This one can be any number, but you have to use this part. Okay. So, and then in your program, you can use the word speed in your program. Is that okay? What happens? This is, so what this one is going to do? What happens is that, what happens, the C language, when it is converted, when it run your program, is going to remove speed and replace it with this number. So here, so this command is pretty easily, you are telling the C language, please go through my program. Every time you see the word speed, replace it with 20. Is that okay? When it is converted. So you may not be seeing it, but when it's converted, when you run the program, right? So, okay. So that you understand it now, you just use English word, and these two English words in different places in your program, this English word should be replaced by a number, okay? So you select this number, okay? Someone can say, okay, but why I overcomplicate this way? Why I don't just write 20, 20, 20 this way, and that's it? I'm gonna tell you why. For sure, there is a reason. The reason is, number one, better readability. Okay, I think there's a mistake. There's this letter A here, readability. What this means, I'm gonna tell you what this means. When you read the program, if I give you a program and you read the program and you see 20, 20, 20, 20, do you understand what this means? No, but if you see speed, you can understand the program easier. Yeah, you are gonna multiply the speed by the time to get the distance so I can, and so on. So you can understand the program easier. So better readability for the program, because this is for human for sure, it's not for the machine, for human. So that when I read the program, I understand. Now you are gonna take the speed, you are gonna read the speed, you are gonna multiply it by something, you are gonna divide it and so on, okay? This is one thing for sure. The other thing, easy to change. Okay, what this means? It means, what if I wanna run my program when the speed is 20 to see if the results are good or not? And if the results are not good, maybe I'm gonna change this number to 25 and to try again. Maybe I'm gonna change it to 50, try again and so on, okay? Here, the good thing here, if I want to change it 20, you're going to change it in only one location. Is that okay? And that's it, only one location. I don't need to go through all my program and to change it. And maybe you make a mistake, you forget, you change all of them except one or two. It's going to make a trouble, right? It's going to make mistakes. You just put it in one place. Anyway, okay? The other thing, so this is what we call, so you understand this one? This is not assembly, this is C language, okay? I'm gonna explain to you how can you do exactly the same thing in assembly using this command, this directive, equate, okay? It's this way, you can say you put name here, whatever the name is, can be any name, and then you have to put equate, you have to use this word, exactly these letters, and then you can put number here, like speed, equate, 50, okay? Number one, this is the format of the instruction, or the directive, number one. Where you can put this one? Can I put it anywhere? No, you are gonna, if you put it anywhere, you are gonna receive error message. Okay, it has to be before the first org. It shouldn't be here. Because so now your program should be, you have a number, you can have some equate here, and then you have one org, you put your data and this org, another org, 4,000. This is 4,000, not 400. And then you put your code here. So it has to be here, is that okay? Is that okay, guys? So it has to be here. You cannot put it here, okay? So you have to put it before this one, okay? It should, by common sense, if you put it here, okay? This is not something I'm gonna store in memory. You got what I'm saying? So here, anything you put here should be stored in memory. Anything you put here should be stored in memory, but this is something that's not gonna be in memory, right? This is be careful here. This is the difference between if you define a variable and call it speed, and between you define a constant and you call it speed, what is the difference? If you define a variable, number one, it has to be here, okay? Number two, this variable should have physical location. So I can, when you run your program, you can read the variable, you can write to the variable, is that okay? But this one is not a variable, it's a constant value, is that okay? So this one should not take any memory location, because when you convert the program to machine code, you are not gonna see it at all, right? Because all what's gonna happen is a assembler is gonna search a new program. Every time it finds a speed, it's gonna replace it with 50, that's it. It's, Again, I hope you are not confused between a variable and between this constant. Is that okay? Variables, they have physical location in memory. You can change them. But this one, you can change the speed before you run the program. Okay, not during the execution time. Yes.
Can the number that we define as the English word, can that be put into binary?
Yeah, for sure. Yeah, you can put it in any format. That's true. Okay, so just use the prefix. Okay, look here, guys. And by the way, we already have done this. By the way, I'm gonna tell you how we did this. Okay, you remember when you included a file? Let me open this file. I'm gonna show you. So you remember this file here? I'm calling it file of constant. Okay, if I open this file, this is the file you include it in the lab, and you have to include it in the beginning. This file, it has a lot of constants, too many equates. You can see here the equates here, okay? So for sure, any semicolon, anything comes after the semicolon, as I told you, so it's just a comment, ignore, okay? So you can see here, just a name, English name, and just equate this value. And you can see there is a dollar sign here. So this value hits this one because there is dollar sign here. Okay, same thing here. Okay, guys? Someone can ask me, how are we gonna use this one later? Okay, I'm gonna tell you how, and this is very interesting. Look here. As I mentioned before, every input-output device should have address. Every input-output device should have address. That means if I wanna write here, I have to use the address of this one. If I want to write here, I have to use the address. Every input output device should have address. Okay, so that in order to make programming easier, okay, instead of, again, we as humans, we don't like to remember numbers, right? We like to use English names, okay? So same thing here. Instead of remembering, if you want to read something from here or here or here, instead of remembering number, no, what I did, I defined all of them here, and you can just use English words. I can give you one example. So let's go to port B. So if you see here, guys, this is port B as here. Okay, guys? So this is the address of port P. Port P, as I'm gonna teach you later, these LEDs are connected to port B. So instead of using the address number one, because address number one is the address for port B, here you can use the English word port B. Is that okay? So make it easy, right? So when I'm gonna use English words, but keep in mind these English words are gonna be replaced by numbers because I don't want to work using numbers. Is that okay, guys? So you can see that's how we will use this file. All of them are equate, okay? We just define constant numbers so that you can use English words and they are gonna be replaced by these numbers because I don't want to memorize them. You can see here, this one is in binary and this one is decimal. So you can see it here, okay? This binary, decimal, and some of them are already hexadecimal. Okay, guys, any questions? So now you should understand, number one, what is equate? Why we use it? Where in the program you put equate? Where? Okay, and also why we use it, why it's useful, and where you put it, and how we use it also, how? Okay, so it has name, equate, number. Oh, any question? Okay, the last directive I'm gonna teach before I move to the next topic is what we call fill. I don't think we are gonna use it much, but anyway, this instruction is used if you wanna fill many locations with one initial value, right? For example, I'm gonna say org 1000, and then I'm gonna say fill, okay, number 20 in 40 locations. So we're gonna come here in 40 location, you are gonna start filling 20, 20, 20, 20, just it. I don't think we're gonna need it, but this is also one of the direct. If you have many location, I wanna put some initial value, right? So this is the easy way to this. Just say fill, put the value, you wanna store it here everywhere. Give me how many locations. So here, 40 locations. So I'm gonna start from 1,000, 40 locations, and I'm gonna put 20, 20, 20, and so. Any questions? Okay. This is the end of the directives here. Again, tomorrow there will be a quiz. The quiz will be similar. You already have a lot of examples, either in the slides. You already have also examples in my handwriting. It's gonna be something like that. Here, I'm gonna give you this part. So the quiz, I'm going to give you something like that here, right? But I'm here, it's byte, no, I'm going to change. So you're going to sum byte, some words, some of them are variable, some of them are arrays, FCC, I also will use FCC. Anyway, so I will use the directives I have. So I'm going to give you something like that. And then I'm going to ask you to get me this one, right? Also, I'm going to ask you in your program when you use E1, what it means. It means this memory is going to be replaced by this memory location. Same thing here, same thing here. Okay. Any questions? Yeah, sure. They are the same. They are the same. Okay. You can use DC.B all the time. I'm totally fine. But if you go to here, what I wrote here, I said it's the same. Let me go. Yeah, look here. DC.B, if you use DC.B or use DB or use FCB, they're the same. But we can just take one and use it most of the time. But in the slide, if you see something different, you should know. Okay. Anyway, any question, guys? So let me go back. I told you any assembly program should have two things. We write directives and also we write commands or instructions. I'm done with directives now. Now I'm going to move to commands or instructions, okay? So before I teach instructions, there is a very, very, very important topic. Very, very important topic. I want you to pay attention to this topic. We need it all the time. A little bit confusing to students. I will do my best to explain it very well. But this topic is called addressing modes. So let me write it here. Again, guys, I'm going to say it again. This is very, very, very important topic. It's confusing to students in the beginning. So please pay attention to me. If you have any question, just raise your hand. So this is what we call addressing modes. Okay. So let's start. So look here, guys. I'm saying here, I'm going to teach commands or instructions, okay? Any command in any programming language, any command should tell two things. Any command should tell two things. Number one, it has to tell operation. What operation you want to do? You want to do multiplication, you want to do division, you want to do add, you want to do logic and, logic or, whatever. There should be an operation. This number one. Is that enough? No, it's not enough to tell me add. Add what? Add what? You have to give me numbers, right? So I have to give me number to add. Is that enough? No, it's not enough. You have to tell me where I have to store the result as well. Is that okay, guys? So you have to give me operation. You have to give me data. And also you have to tell me where I have to store the result as well. Okay, for example, so the operand here should have source and destination of data. So what you mean by source? Okay, I mean by source, if you want to add two numbers, you have to tell me where I have to get these two numbers. These two numbers can be two registers. So I'm going to get the numbers in the registers. It can be two memory locations. So you have to tell me what is the source of the data. I have to do this operation on this data. Is that okay? Also, you have to tell me the destination. Destination here means after I get the result, where I have to store it. Okay, so after I add, where the result should come from. Okay, so it's like something like what, this is similar to what you did before. For example, if you say J should equal I plus K in C language, what this means? This is an instruction, okay? Because I have operation, the operation is addition. This is the operation, okay? This is number one. Number two, I have a source. This is the source of the data. I and K, okay? So this is a source. I'm gonna get these two values. I'm gonna do the addition. Also, this is the destination. So you are telling me I have to store the result here. Okay, so in general, for any instruction, you have to give me operation. You have to give me what we call operand, okay? And these operands should be source and destination of the data, okay? So now, In assembly, what operands we may have, okay? It can be in assembly, the operands you have, it can be register. For example, I want to add register to register. It can be memory location, like I and K. So here, I is a memory location, K is memory location. This one also is memory location. So any operand Any operand can be a register, can be a memory location, also can be immediate value. What do you mean by immediate value? I'm going to tell you what I mean by, for example, I can say here, guys, I want to add I plus number 70. Is that okay? You know how this instruction works? I'm going to get the content of I. So whatever value of I, because I is a memory location. So I'm going to get the value of I. Then I'm going to add number 70, right? This is what we call immediate value, okay? So anyway, what I'm saying, guys, now, any operand can be one of three things. Can be register, the content of a register. It can be a the content of a memory location. And also it can be immediate value. This is for the source of your data, source. Destination can be a register and only memory location. For sure, it cannot be immediate value. Again, destination means this is where you are gonna store the result, okay? So because register is a location, I can store data there. Memory is a location, I can store data there, okay? So anyway, so in here in assembly, operands can be one of three things. All of them can be source, but only these two can be destination. Is that okay, guys? So let me give you more example to understand what I wanna say. This, by the way, this is not assembly. So we're not gonna do it this way in assembly. I just explained to you operation. I wanna do something like that. Register A, I wanna add register A to number 20, okay? And then I'm gonna store the result in register A. This is how it is done. So I'm gonna get the content of register A, whatever is there, I'm gonna add number 20. That's why you call it immediate value, okay? Immediate value, because it's almost 20. But A may change, right? So A is like a container. A can store 70, 20, 80, can change. But it's a constant number. We call it immediate value, okay? Immediate value means a constant number. So that's exactly what we're gonna do. I'm gonna get the content of register A, whatever is there, I'm gonna add 20, then I'm gonna store the result in A, right? Any questions? Let's see something else. Here, I wanna add register A to register B, and then store the result in A, right? So the source, this is the source, this is a destination. So I'm gonna get whatever in A, whatever in B, I'm gonna add them together, and then I'm gonna store the result in A. Is that okay? Here the operands are registers. Again, don't forget, we have the operands can be registered, it can be memory location, it can be immediate values. Let's have another one here. If I have A should equal memory, the content of the memory location, 1000 plus 20. If you wanna do something like that, what this means? It means I'm gonna get the content of memory location, 1000, whatever is there, okay? Whatever is there, I'm gonna add it to 20 because this is memory, right? So it's a container, I'm gonna get whatever is there. But this one is constant value. So I'm gonna add 20, then the result is gonna go to A. So this one is immediate value, this one is memory, this one is register, okay? Same thing, I can do this way. I can say I wanna add a register to 20, and then I wanna store the result in a memory this way. So I'm gonna get whatever in A, I'm gonna add 20, and then the result is gonna be stored in 1000. Is that okay, guys? We agree on that? Any questions? Is that okay? Okay, now. So we agreed now. When you write your instruction, you need operation and you need operands, right? And these operands can be register, can be memory location, can be immediate value. So now, in your instruction, how can you express if it is immediate value? How can you express it? How can you write it? If it is a register, how can you do that? If it is memory location, how can you do that? That's what I'm gonna elaborate now, okay? So let's see. Number one, let's start with immediate value, constant value, immediate value, okay? If it is, how the assembler can know this is immediate value, how it can know, right? If it is immediate value, you have to put here hashtag, or you call it hashtag, or you call it bound sign, whatever you wanna call it, okay? Hashtag or bound sign. So you have to put bound size before the number. What this means? It means if I do something like that, load register A with number 20. Once you see this hashtag, that means this is not a memory location. It's not a register. It's number 20. Okay. So I didn't teach instructions yet, but in order to explain the addressing modes, I'm gonna use two instructions: load and store. So load instruction is used to copy if you want to copy immediate value or a content of a memory location to one register. So if I have a register, if I want to put a number in register A, so I can use loot. If I want to, if I now want to read the byte in memory and put it in register A, I'm going to use loot. Okay. A store is the opposite. So a store is used if you want to store register A, okay, or one of the register, you want to copy one of the register, store it in memory location. Anyway, I'm going to teach you all instructions later, but for now, in order to explain this part, I need to use some instructions, okay? In other words, loot and load. Register should equal to immediate value. Okay, guys? I know you may be a little bit confused because every language you learned it before, if you want to do something like I is equal to 2, you use this equal. Here, we don't have equal. Instead of this equal, we're going to use load or store. You got what I'm saying? So this instruction here, load register A with number 20. So once you see this one is means number 20, okay? So this one is equivalent to A is equal to 20, but we don't have this one in assembly. We're going to do it using instruction this way, okay? Again, I'm not teaching instruction now, so don't worry. I'm going to teach instructions later. I just want to explain here. If it is in constant value or immediate value, how can you do that? Very easy, just to put hashtag, very easy, right? So something like that, right? Load register B with number 20. Once you see the hashtag, this is not a memory location, it's not a register, it's a number 20, constant, okay? So here that means, I'm saying that, guys, because after a few minutes, I'm gonna tell you, if you remove the hashtag, it becomes a memory location. Is that okay? So if I remove, that's what you are gonna see right now. Without hashtag, that means memory location number 20, which is completely different thing. But with hashtag, that means it's number 20, it's not a memory location, okay? Anyway, so that in this instruction, load B with 20, so that I want B should equal to 20. I told you before, when I use a bracket this way, I mean, this is not a programming, but this is just something we are gonna use in comments or something like that. Once I use bracket here, I mean the content of this location. So in tomorrow or in a quiz, if I give you a bracket, bracket 1000 means I'm asking you what is the content of this location, okay? Again, this is not programming. We're not gonna use it in programming, okay? Now, let's have more example. When I say load X is the register X, okay? And this instruction is used if you want to copy a word. And then hashtag, because we have hashtag here, that means this is a number, it's not memory. I'm going to take this number, I put it in X. So what this instruction is doing is going to do this one. Okay, don't be confused. This is not a symbol. This is the meaning, or this is what this instruction is doing, okay? If you want to do something like an assembly, you have to do it this way, okay? Same thing if you say load A 20. So here, this instruction load A is used if you want to copy if you want to copy a byte. So this is 20 is a byte, so I'm going to store 20 in A. 20 is going to be stored in a byte, okay? However, if I say load X hashtag 20, whatever the number here, so it's going to be stored in a word, which is X, okay? So this one is going to be stored in a word, X. Okay? Same thing, I can do this way, guys. I can say load register A, and then hashtag, and then I put percent here, right? Instead of dollar sign, I put percent. Or I may remove the percent. Yeah, that's totally fine, okay? Just to define the format of the number. So you can put dollar sign. If the number is hexadecimal, you can put percent, or you can put, you don't put prefix, that means it is decimal. Okay, guys? Any questions? Again, once you see hashtag, it means it's a number, constant number. It's not memory. Why can you said it for three or four times? Because you would be confused later. I'm afraid you will confuse later and then tell me, you see the hashtag, then I'm going to go to this memory location. Man, this hashtag, man, it's a constant number. There's no memory here. Okay, anyway. Because just to give me a few minutes, I'm going to tell you, if we remove this hashtag, now this one becomes a memory location. And I have to take it from memory. But this one, there is no memory here. Anyway. So now, okay. So again, I told you the operand. The operand can be one of three things. It can be immediate value. It can be a register. It can be memory, right? I'm done. I am done with the immediate value. Immediate value means hashtag, but I'm done. Okay. Now, what if the operand is a register? How I can do that? Very simple. The way we're gonna do when I teach instructions, the way you are gonna do it, I'm gonna just use the name of the register. That's it. Okay, if you mean register A, just write A. If you mean register B, just write B. That's it. So if your operand is a register, just use the name of the register. Okay, that's it. So for example, I'm gonna give you again. You have an instruction. This instruction is called the transfer. This instruction is transfer, and then you have to put here a register and then comma, and you put here a register. What this instruction is doing, you copy this register to this register. You copy the content of this register to this register. So this is the source and this is the destination. Again, don't worry about assembly. I didn't teach any assembly yet. Okay. So I'm just giving you, here I'm focusing on operands, okay? I'm gonna teach everything later entities, okay? So now, so here, this instruction called the transfer, this instruction, what you have to put after this instruction is actually two register, you have to separate them by comma. And this one, this instruction should copy register to register. So now, what I care about now, if you mean a register, okay, how I can do that? If you mean immediate value, you have to use hashtag. I would explain it. Now, if you mean this register, how can you do that? Very easy. Just use the name of the register or the letter of the register. For example, if I say transfer A comma B, what this means? It means I want to copy the content of A and put it in B. Okay, so this is equivalent to B is equal to A. So after you execute this instruction, okay, or this instruction in C language. So again, we don't have this instruction assembly. If you want to do this one in assembly, we don't have equal. We have an instruction that can do equal, right? So if you want to do some, you know, after you execute this instruction, the value of A is gone. The value of B is gone, and B and A should be have the same value of A. So after you have A and B, right? So after you execute this value, I'm gonna copy A to B. Okay, that means the old value of B is gone, right? Same thing here. Okay, now, so what I'm explaining here is I need to put here a register and I need to put here a register, okay? How I can do that? Just to put the letter of the register. That's it, letter, A comma B. Or I can say transfer X comma Y. So that means I'm gonna copy register X to register Y. That's it, okay? Again, maybe some students still a little bit confused about what do you mean by copy? I mean, if this is the register A, guys, and this is the register B, and this one, for example, is storing 70, this one is storing F2, right, for example. So if I say transfer A comma B, that means I'm gonna copy A to B. So after I execute this instruction, this is a source. We don't change the source. For any instruction, we don't change the source. We change the destination. So A is gonna continue 70 after you execute this instruction. However, B should become 70 because you copy this one to this one. So this one is gonna be deleted. Or you are gonna overwrite it. It's gonna be gone, overwrite it. Is that okay, guys? Any questions? I'm done with this one as well. Okay, easy. But the coming one, it's easy, but confusing. So this is a difficult one. Believe me, it's not difficult if you pay attention to what I'm saying, okay? So let me summarize what I said before I go to this case. What I'm saying, guys, for any command, I have to tell what operation, which is easy. Also, I have to tell what operands you are gonna use. I told you, for operands, it can be a register, it can be memory location, or it can be immediate value, which is very easy. For immediate value, hashtag. If this hashtag, it's not memory, please. It's not memory, hashtag number. It's a constant number, okay? No memory. And then register, just use the name of the register or the letter A, B, X, D, Y, and so on. Okay, if it is a register, this is how you can use it in instruction, okay? Now, memory location. What do you mean by memory location? I mean, if you see the examples I have here, for example, this is a memory location and this is a source. So look here, this is a source, not destination. So I'm getting, source means I have to read the number in this memory location, right? This is a source. So you have to tell me the address. As you know, memory has too many addresses. If it is a memory location, all what I need to know is the address. Just say, tell me what is the address. Just say, is that okay? Here it is a destination. So after I do the addition, I have to write the results in the memory. The memory has too many locations. Tell me which location. So you have to tell me the address. Is that okay, guys? That's what I'm gonna teach it this way. Okay. So let's go to for memory. Yeah, operand in memory. Okay, guys, look here. In memory, there are two ways to do it in memory. Okay, one way we call it direct or extended addressing mode. So one way we call it direct or addressing or extended. I'm gonna tell you what I mean by why you call it direct and extended. I'm gonna tell you direct or extended addressing mode. Or it can be indexed. So there are two ways, okay? Direct or extended or indexed. Okay, guys? Okay. Now I'm gonna give you the details. First, what is the difference between them? Very simple. Index it means pointer. Index it means I'm gonna use a pointer here, okay? So let's start with this one first. So in this one, guys, this one, again, remember, in both cases, I need address. But the way I'm gonna give you the address is different. But in both cases, you need to give me address. At the end, I should have address, right? So for example, if you tell me it's address number 7000, so if I want to read, if this is a source, I'm going to read the data store in itself. If this is a destination, so I'm going to write to 7000. So whatever the format you are using, if you are using extended or you use it, index it, in both cases, I need to get address at the end. But the way you are going to give me the address is different. I'm going to tell you how, okay? And so let's start. So here, in direct or extended, here, how you will give me the address here? Memory means you will give me the address. So how you will give me the address? Okay, I'm gonna just give you the address. I'm gonna tell you location number 20, that's it. So for example, when I say load A, 20, no hashtag here. Because there is no hashtag, that means this is a memory and this is location number 20, right? So this instruction is gonna read a byte, is gonna read a byte from location number 20 in the memory, is gonna store it in register A. So here it has to be this way. I'm gonna get a byte from location number 20. Is that okay, guys? Okay, so let's have more examples here. Okay, for example, when I say load A 10 without hashtag, what this one, if once you see this one, this again, this topic is very important, guys. It's confusing, we are gonna use it all the time. Usually some students get confused in the beginning, okay? But you will understand it anyway, okay? Because you are gonna use it all the semester, right? So hopefully you understand from the beginning, it's gonna be much better than you understand it later, okay? So that's why I'm doing my best to explain it, okay? So what I'm saying, so this one means no hashtags, that means this is a memory location, okay? So here load A, 10. So that means you are gonna read a byte. I'm gonna read a byte from location number 10. 10 is a location address. So I'm gonna read whatever is there, as you see here, guys. So I'm gonna read a byte, then I'm gonna put it in register A. Okay, so here also, but if you put hashtag, now the story is completely different. No memory. If you put hashtag, no memory. Just put number 10 in A. Okay, you see the difference between them? Okay, let's have another example. I told you about store instruction. Store is the opposite of load. Load, you read and you put it in a register. Store, you wanna copy a register to a memory location, as you see here, okay? So if I, so here, okay, let me tell you. So store means I'm gonna store a memory content of a memory location or immediate value to a register. But store means I want to store the value of a register in memory location, right? So now the destination is a memory location, okay? It cannot be immediate value. Immediate value is not a container. It's not a location where I can go and store some value, right? So destination cannot be immediate value. Anyway, so let's see. If I have an instruction like this one, guys, don't be confused. Once you see a number without hashtag, a number without hashtag, so this is a memory location. Done, memory location. No hashtag, No hashtag, memory location. So this is a memory location, and this instruction should store the content of register A in this memory location 2000, okay, as you see here. So this is register A, and this is the memory location 2000. So I'm gonna take whatever there, I'm gonna store it in this location. Again, you can ask me, so what about the old value here? The old value is gone. For example, if register A is storing number 30, and there was 70 here, okay? So once I do the addition, 70 is gone. So I'm gonna put 30 here, you overwrite, it's gone, right? Same thing like when you did in high level programming language, when I say I is equal to 7, and then I is equal to 10. So where is 7? 7 is gone, right? Because I'm gonna overwrite, so it's gone, okay? Any question, guys? Okay? Okay, let's have one example. When I say load A 1000, that means I'm gonna read a byte from location number 1000, put it in A because this is a memory location, done. But when I see hashtag here, that means this is a number, it's not memory location, it's a number, okay guys? And by the way, this instruction is wrong. This instruction is wrong, you know why? Because you wanna store 1000 in register A. This is a word and this is a byte. This one is correct. So this one is correct. This one is wrong, right? Because you wanna store 1000, number 1000 in A is a byte, right? So this is too big to put in a byte, okay? So this is wrong. But this one here, I'm gonna read a byte from location 1000, okay, guys? And like what I told you before, also this is a little bit confusing. Please, this part is very important. If you have any question, stop me, raise your hand, okay? What I'm saying also here. Look here, guys, for example, if this is location 1000 and this is location 1001, for example, we have here 3A, we have F2, for example, okay, guys? 1000, when you use 1000 here, guys, maybe I'm gonna read a byte, or maybe it means I'm gonna read a word. It depends on the instruction. How can you know? So in both cases, I'm gonna give you only one address, 1000. Why? Because if it is a word, so automatically you are gonna take 1000 and next one. So I don't need to say, read a word from 1000 and 1001. I don't need to say that. Just tell me, read a word from 1000. Automatically, I'm gonna get the next one. Is that okay? Yeah. So in both cases, I'm gonna just write 1000. So you are telling me, it's really confusing. You're just telling me 1000. And sometimes you just read one value and sometimes you read two, that's true. How can I know? From the instruction itself. When I teach every instruction, I'm gonna tell you this instruction is gonna read the byte, or this instruction is gonna read the word. Okay, so let me give you an example here, okay? So the example here, guys, if I say load, let me use. If I say load A 1000, okay, guys? When I teach you this instruction, I'm gonna tell you this instruction is gonna read a byte, okay? So this one is gonna read 3A, one location is a byte, and then it's gonna store it in register A. So register A should equal 3A. Is that okay? Because this one is gonna read the byte. However, if I say load D or load X or load Y, as I'm gonna explain later, this instruction should work on words, not bytes, okay? That means, and also look here, in both cases, I'm gonna say 1000. That's what I'm explaining right now, guys. So here I said 1000. Here I said 1000, right? However, this instruction is gonna take a byte from 1000, which is 3A. But this instruction, because it works on words, this one is gonna read the word from 1000. So actually you are gonna read 3A, F2. We are gonna put it in register G. Any questions? Yes.
Can you say again what the difference is between store and load?
Okay, great. Load is used. Let me write somewhere here. So you have a register. If you wanna put immediate value, like for example, number 20 in a register, any register, okay? Or if you wanna get content of a memory location, put it in a register, this is load. So load is used if I wanna store immediate value in a register or memory location to a register. Is that okay? A store is a, is a store. If you have a register and I want to store the register in a memory location. Is that okay? Great, thanks. Okay, guys, so you understand here, this one, I'm gonna read the byte from 1000. So I'm gonna take, again, I don't need to say 1000 and 1001 because always, always, if it is a word, I'm gonna take this address and next one. So just give me one and automatically I'm gonna get the next one, okay? That's what we are doing here. So let's go through these ones again quickly. So if I say load A 1000, so I'm gonna read the byte at the location 1000, put it in A, right? If I do something like that, no, this is wrong. You know why this one is wrong? It's wrong because you want to store number 1000, which is a word, you want to store it in a byte. Okay, this one has no memory, so this is wrong. But if I do this one, this one is correct because you want to store 1000 in register D. Register D is a word, so it should be okay, right? So here, or X or Y, okay? So this one, it's okay, it's a word. You store a word in a word, should be okay. Here, you are gonna store a word at the memory location 1000, put it in G, okay? Again, guys, once you see the hashtag, means this is not memory. Once you know hashtag, means this is a memory. And in case of memory, sometimes you are gonna read a byte, sometimes you are gonna read the word, it depends on the instruction. Okay, guys, any questions? Also, this one is okay. Don't be confused, guys, please. This one also should be okay. I want to store number 20 in register D. It's totally fine. Someone can tell me, but 20 is a byte. Okay, what's the problem? 20, I can store it as a number. I can store it in a, no one, I cannot say 20 is a byte. I can say 20, a byte should be enough to store 20. Yeah, that's true. But I can store it in a word, I can store in double word and so on. So it's not wrong. This is wrong because this is the space. This is a word, you want to store it in a byte. But this one, yes, byte is enough, but I want to store it in a word. That's okay. You can do that, okay? Just a bigger space. Bigger space is okay, but smaller space, no. Okay. I think I explained this one. If I say load A 1000, you are gonna get whatever is there, one byte, put it in A. But if I say load D 1000, so you are gonna take two bytes, put it them in G. And we agreed on the order. We agreed on the order. So the order is, I'm gonna take 1000 and 1001. And the first one is the most significant. So it should be FF3A. It's not 3AFF. So this one, the first one you read is the most significant. The next one is the least significant. Okay, guys, any questions? So far, so easy. Okay, so now let me summarize what I said. What I said for operands, I explained so far three. I explained if it's immediate value, hashtag, and then put a number. If it's a register, just use the letter of the register. Okay, just number two. Number three, if it is a memory location, if it is extended or direct or extended address mode, give me the address. This is the address. Okay, guys. Now, this also is easy. So this is store A in 2000. So I'm gonna get whatever in A, I'm gonna put it in location 2000, okay? It's just one byte. But when I say store X in 2000, when I teach this instruction, I'm gonna tell you this instruction for a word. So I'm gonna take X, I'm gonna store it in two locations, 2000 and 2001. And look at the order. So most significant first and then the least significant, okay? So you copy register X. So X is the source. So this instruction is not gonna change X. X is the source, right? Anyway, so you are telling us this is called the direct or extended. What do you mean by direct or extended? Why two names? Why it's not one name? It's very small difference, not a big deal. It's not a big deal. The reason is, if the address is between 00 and FF, so in this range, we call this one direct mode. If it is more than that, we call it extended mode, okay? For example, this one is direct mode. This one is extended mode. So how this matters? Look, it doesn't matter too much for you, but just the only difference is that This one takes less space in memory, less space. You know why? Because this address is going to take only one byte. But machine code, I'm talking about when you say convert this one to machine code. This one is going to take less space, so one byte, but this one is going to take bigger space, 2 bytes. Anyway, so I don't see any difference between them, so don't worry about it. So I just want to tell you why we call it direct and extended, okay? So it's not going to make a difference, just, okay? Now, let's move to the next. Let me come to this step. I told you guys, for memory can be direct or extended, and that's easy. Once you see a number without hashtag, this is a memory right away. Now, let's go to what we call indexed address rules. This is needs focus. You need to focus here. This is a little bit confusing, okay? This one, we call it indexed addressing mode. Again, the word indexed here means pointer, okay? Some of you already familiar with what pointer means. Some of you don't, okay? I'm not familiar with that. So I'm gonna do my best to understand what I mean by pointer. And actually we have two pointers here we're gonna use all the time. We have pointer, I'm gonna call it X, and register X and register Y. So usually we are going to use register X and Y as pointers. So they are pointers, okay? So what I mean by pointer, is, look here guys, it is very useful, especially when you read or write arrays, as I explained before, okay? This is an array, this is location, 7001, 7002, 7003, and so on, okay? I want to read this array. How I'm gonna read this array, I'm gonna take the first address, I'm gonna put it in register X. So I am register X, okay? And then I'm gonna ask, then I wanna read the byte pointed by X. So what is the address? The address is in X, okay? So the address 7000 is in X. When I read the byte pointed by X, I'm gonna get the first element. So, okay? Now, I wanna get the element number 2. So I'm gonna increment X. So now X is 7001. Right? Then I'm going to get the byte point by X and so on, increment X. Same idea like PC. The same idea like PC is exactly the same thing. But PC is used when you read instructions. But PC was a pointer, right? PC, the way I explained PC, it was a pointer, right? But it was a pointer for instruction. Now, we're going to use X and Y also as pointers, by pointers for arrays. If you have array, you got what I'm saying? So now, listen to me, what I'm saying, you can guess. The main difference between this mode and this mode, the main difference is, here, I just give you the address directly, 20. Remember, in both cases, I need address. You need to give me address in both cases. But the way I'm gonna give you the address is different. Here, I just give you the number. Here, I'm gonna use the register X and Y to give you the number. Okay, so if I wanna, so for example, if I wanna get the location pointed by X, so the address should be inside X, because X is a pointer, okay? Anyway, so for, again, most of the time, we're gonna use this one for arrays. So usually this one is gonna be used for arrays, okay? So for this one, we have three formats. I'm doing my best to make it very easy. If you find any of these formats, don't think about it. It's memory. When you see one of these format, the operand is memory, right? So let's see the format. The first format here, it's a constant number, comma, register X or Y. This is operand. Like 0, comma X, 1, comma X, 2, comma X. It can be positive, or also it can be negative number, okay? So if you see constant number, comma X or Y, so this is the operand. Okay, so once you see this one operand, it's not two, it's one operand, memory, and it's memory. Once you see this for me, for sure, I'm gonna give you details. For now, and also the second format is, you can use register A, B, or D, comma, register X or Y. So it can be like A, comma X, B, comma X, D, comma Y, and so on. So once you see this format, that means this is also memory, okay? Don't worry, I'm gonna give you more details. I'm gonna explain what this one means and why we use it. This same here. I just, for now, what's important is, once you see operand, you should know this operand is a number or a memory. And if it is a memory, how can you get the address? Because if it is a memory, all what I need just address, right? So let's also look at this one. This one, it has a number, as you see here, comma, X or Y, But you have a plus or minus, as you see here. So plus can be here. Plus can be boost or pre. So that's why it's called auto increment or decrement. So if you see something like that, again, number, comma, X or Y, and also there is plus or minus. This plus or minus can be before or after the end, X or Y, as you see here. Okay, again, now let's go to the details. This is a big picture. Again, what I'm saying, memory should have four formats for memory. Number one, something like that, just a number, this is a memory, this number one. Number two, constant comma X, constant comma Y, and so on. Number three, A comma X, A or B comma X. So once you see something like this, it's a memory, right? Same thing here, constant comma X, right? But we have plus or minus, okay? Now let's go to the details, okay, guys? So let's see what this one means, how can we use this one? But keep in mind, when I explain the details, every time I'm gonna tell you what is the address, because as long as it's memory, I need the address. Is that okay? But the way you are gonna calculate the address is somehow different. You are saying calculate the address, so the address should be calculated? Yes, because it's a pointer, right? Here I just give you the address directly, but in case of pointer, you have to do some operation to calculate the address, because it's a pointer, okay? So I'm gonna show you now. So let's go. So let's start with the first case. First case, I told you we have a constant comma X or Y, and this constant can be positive or negative. So what is the address here? The address is actually, for example, 2 comma X. Again, this is one operand, it's just a memory location, okay? Once you see something like that, it's a memory location, okay? So for a memory location, I should know the address. Yes, the way we are gonna do it, this is register X, this is number 2. I'm gonna get whatever in X, I'm gonna add 2, and then this is the address, I'm gonna go to memory, and then I'm gonna read byte or word, okay? So once you see constant comma X, that means you need to calculate that the address is, you are gonna add the content of X plus 2, right? And this is gonna give you the address, and then from this address, you can read or write, okay? Byte or word. Also, this instruction does not change X. I take whatever in X, add 2, and then I'm gonna get the address. It does not change X. Why you are saying that? Because later, when I come to this once here, I'm gonna tell you this instruction is gonna increment X or increment Y. But this instruction, it does not change the pointer X. So the value of X will be the same, okay? But here, now, the only one that's actually change X or Y is this one. Again, remember, don't be confused, please. X or Y should have address, right? So I'm gonna use it as a pointer to point at a location, okay? So, okay, it looks easy. It looks, for example, when I say one comma, for example, if I do something like that, guys, load register A, 0 comma X, what it means? It means this one is a byte. This is a memory location, because this is one of the format of the memory location. I'm gonna read the byte from this memory location, put it here. Okay, so what is the address? Memory location means you have to tell me what is the address here. The address, I have to calculate it because this is a pointer. I have to calculate it. How you can calculate it? I'm gonna add the value of X plus the constant here, okay? Here, because the constant is 0, it doesn't matter, so 0. But if it is a number, I have to add it to X. So what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna get the constant here. I'm gonna add it to X again, because it's 0, it doesn't matter. It's 0, right? But I'm giving you in general, if you have any constant here, I have to add it to X. And then this will be, give me the address here. And then from, once I have the address, okay, so this instruction is gonna read the byte, so I'm gonna read only one location. Is that okay, guys? Okay, let's see another example. If I do something like that, load register D, and I told you load register D, this one should read a word to location, a word, okay? And then once you see something like that, yeah, this is a memory, right? Where is the address? Address is actually X plus 1. So I'm gonna get whatever in X plus 1, I'm gonna get the address. Again, as long as there is a pointer, I need to calculate the address using the pointer, okay? But if it is direct addressing mode, memory, you just give me the number, you just give me the address. I don't need to calculate. So I'm gonna get whatever in X, I'm gonna add 1, and then this will give me the address, okay? So this is the address here. And because I'm going to read the word. So I'm going to take these two bytes, the one at this address and next one as well. This is similar to what we did before. In both cases, if you want to read byte or word, just give me one address. If it is a byte, I'm going to just read this location. If it is a word, so I'm going to read this location and next one automatically, right? Any questions? Yes.
So when it reads an X, it reads in the value of the X register?
Yeah, because X should point at a location. So whatever is stored in this location, I know. It is also a very good point because usually students are confused in this part. Is that address or content of the address? Yeah, I know. For example, let have number. For example, if X is storing number 1000, so this is, so 1000 is address because it's a point. Always any pointer should store address, right? So if I add one, so now my address here is just, so this one here is similar to if you give me 1001, this one. So location 1001, okay? If you give me location 1001 and you ask me to read a byte, so I'm gonna need only 1001. If you ask me to read a word, so I'm gonna need 1001 and next one. Is that okay? And after you execute this instruction, that's what I'm gonna do in the quiz, but not this week, next week. I'm gonna make a quiz and I just wanna make sure you understand it. So this instruction does not change X. Okay, so what I'm gonna do in the quiz, I'm gonna give you this instruction, okay guys? And then I'm gonna tell you what is the value of X? What is the value of X, right? So here X should not change. This instruction does not change X. So if X is 1000, it should continue 1000. Is that okay? Just last slide, because last slide here. So that's what I'm explaining right now. So if X is 1000, before this instruction, it's still X is 1000. This one does not change X. Okay, guys? So see you tomorrow in the lab. As I told you tomorrow, number one, you have to submit assignment one, right? Number two, we are gonna have a quiz. I told you what would be in the quiz. Okay, number three, we are gonna do a lab. This lab should have like a free lab. You have to do it, okay? There's one part in the free lab, I think it's a minute, so maybe I'm gonna submit tomorrow, okay? The remaining two, the auto increment and decrement. Okay, so I'm gonna explain it tomorrow. Okay, so you can pick it fine. Yeah. Yes. Not this week. Next week. Okay. Yes. Yes. Yeah, for homework, for anything, guys, you wanna give it to us, print, write your name and print it, give it to us, we're gonna grade it, and it will be given to you next week. Is that okay? Whatever you want to make it hand related to the computer or whatever it is, okay. Since you are talking about assignment, you have to make a distinction. Okay, this hand related to the computer, whatever it is.